Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at DutchPod101.com.
Ah, maybe first you can pretend like you know the person from somewhere, okay? That always works.
Nice to meet you.
Hey. Wait, wait, that's English.
Yeah.
Hola, Maca. Me han dit que et dius Anja? És correcte?
Very sexy inside.
Mexican?
No,
Mexican sounds good.
Is it Spanish?
No.
No.
Va, que et llegiré una frase. D'acord?
Yes.
Portuguese?
No.
So maybe it's Spain. Spanish, like...
It's in Spain.
How do they say it? Maybe I don't know how to say in English. Catalonese?
Yeah.
Really?
Catalan.
Oh, really?
Hola. ¿Cómo estás? Hola, Max. ¿Cómo estás? La verdad es que te iba a tirar un chamuyo barato, pero te vi los ojos y no sé, te quiero invitar a salir, te quiero para algo serio. La verdad que no soy de hacer estas cosas, es raro en mí. Pero desde el momento en el que te vi, estoy sintiendo cosas que antes no sentía. No sé qué me está pasando. Y no sé si es tu voz o tu sonrisa, pero me parece que tenemos que ir a tomar algo juntos. Así que lo que voy a hacer es darte mi número de teléfono, me vas a escribir, tal vez nos vamos a enamorar, no sé. Veremos qué pasa. ¿Está bien?
No sé.
I know.
Wow. This is like love confession.
I have to admit that it was like kind of romantic, like the pronunciation and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But like, yeah, the content is a bit cheesy. Yeah. Wow. Sorry about that.
Is it Spanish language, right?
I don't know. You think so?
Yeah.
Es castellano. Exactamente.
我喜欢跟你在一起的感觉。 我能请你喝杯东西吗? 你怎么那么可爱?
It was so sudden, I don't know.
This is easy.
Are you willing to come to my place afterwards? Yeah, just like to be kind of like spice things up a bit.
Like it's Mandarin.
Yes.
How come you know?
I've got a lot of Chinese friends.
Aww.
라면 먹고 갈래?
Okay.
No. This is obvious for me.
It means, do you want to drop by my house and eat instant noodle with me?
This sounds like something like Chinese or Vietnamese to me.
Do you really use it? I mean, or it's just like...
This line is from a movie, actually everyone knows. Yeah, ta.
That's it.
Yeah, ta.
Korean, right?
Okay, so let's say Korean.
But please remember this line. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
This line is usually used by female.
Oh,
so it's like I will
try. Today I will try.
Yeah. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
Yeah.
どこかでお会いしたことありますか?
ないと思います.
今度一緒にご飯でもどうですか?
まだ食べた.
It means no, maybe. I didn't expect the answer.
I didn't expect Japanese.
僕が必ず君を守るから.
Oh, I got excited.
And now I get really shy because she understands.
I understand you.
It means like I'm going to protect you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they don't say in real world.
Yeah. But sometimes you see drama. In drama. Yeah, drama. But it's too romantic,
yeah.
I think.
I want to give a message from here to the world. Mm-hmm. Don't watch so much drama. Come and experience real life first, right?
That's true.
Du är så vacker. Så det ger solen en anledning att skina.
Wow.
Wow. This one is hard.
You're so beautiful. Mm-hmm. You give the sun a reason to shine.
Wow.
It doesn't look like something European or... I feel like it's it might be indie.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. Dina läppar smakar som vin och ikväll vill jag bli berusad.
Okay, like it looks so different to me right now. Like I feel like it's something European right now and like something Germanic, but not German.
Hint.
What's the letter it starts with?
The letter it starts with? S.
Can you say it again? This one?
Yeah.
Not because I like the compliment.
Yeah. I'll say it as many times as you like. Om det hade varit kriminellt att vara snygg, hade du fått livstid.
Okay, this is like something European because I hear no criminal.
Du är så, you said, right?
Du är så.
Du är så. Is it a European language?
Yes.
Swedish?
Holy cow.
Swedish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, because I have friends from Sweden.
Ah.
Hello again.
Oh, you're a beautiful girl.
You are a girl.
What? I thought it was a girl.
What, really? Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hey.
Difficult.
Usually I've got some bad stereotypes about like Spanish, but the Spanish one was quite good, I think. But that's not the winner. To me, like, okay. I think it was Korean, mainly because I couldn't understand like what it meant.
I don't know. I just think Spanish sounds maybe the most sexiest of the languages I've heard today. Yeah, I didn't know much of Catalan, the sound of that, and that was really nice as well. Now, since my husband is Korean, Korean was attractive, I think, because that's why maybe I fell in love with him, right? But also, it's really hard to decide because Castellano and also the Canton language, it sounds also very attractive. I don't know, maybe it's because of their tonation. I don't know why, but even though I don't know the meaning, it sounds like very natural, very confident. So I like that language too.
Hallo iedereen, mijn naam is Gabriella. Elk jaar op 14 februari is het Valentijnsdag. Eén dag per jaar, geheel in het teken van romantiek, liefde en een klein beetje mystiek. Geheime aanbidders veroveren hun geliefde door gedichten en chocolade. Postbodes worden opgewacht en brieven, ook wel Valentijns genoemd, worden met trillende handen opengemaakt. In deze les gaan we u leren hoe Valentijnsdag wordt gevierd in Nederland. Weet u welke bloem naast de roos ook symbool staat voor de liefde? We zullen het antwoord aan u laten zien aan het eind van deze video. Op 14 februari, rond het jaar 300, werd een jonge Romein, Valentijn genaamd, geslagen en onthoofd, omdat hij het christendom niet wilde verloochenen. Voor het dochtertje van de gevangenenbewaarder, die hem bewaakte en met wie hij bevriend was geworden, liet hij een briefje achter. Met daarop de tekst van je Valentijn. Sindsdien werd deze dag een dag voor de vriendschap. Rond de middeleeuwen werd dit verhaal gecombineerd met de vruchtbaarheid van de liefdesgod Cupido en ontstond Valentijnsdag zoals we dat nu kennen, de dag van de liefde. Tot ongeveer 70 jaar geleden had Nederland niet veel met Valentijnsdag. Eind jaren 40 ging het namelijk niet goed met de binnenlandse vraag naar bloemen, in tegenstelling tot de geweldige export ervan. Het voorstel van een bestuurslid van de Nederlandse bloemisterij en Valentijn ook in Nederland in te voeren, bracht hier verandering in. Juist rond de Valentijnsdag worden de grootste hoeveelheden bloemen aan Amerika verkocht en geëxporteerd. Waarom Valentijnsdag dan niet vieren in ons eigen land? In Nederland had Valentijnsdag aanvankelijk het karakter van een dag voor vriendschap. Een dag voor het uiten van gevoelens van respect en waardering. Niet speciaal tegenover je liefde, maar ook naar bijzondere mensen. De Nederlandse tv-programma's zijn dan ook in de ban van de romantiek. En zijn tv-programma's als All You Need Is Love en Love Letters ontzettend populair. In deze programma's worden geliefden weer bij elkaar gebracht, na van elkaar gescheiden te zijn geweest. De liefdesdokter brengt ze dan weer bij elkaar en geeft de partners de mogelijkheid om op tv elkaar te zeggen hoeveel ze van elkaar houden. Valentijnsdag in Nederland lijkt geen aanleiding te geven tot creativiteit. De laatste 10 jaar zijn de populairste geschenken hetzelfde gebleven. Op 14 februari zijn parfum, lingerie en bloemen nog steeds de meest populaire verrassingen. En nu het antwoord op de quiz van zojuist. Weet u welke bloem naast de roos ook symbool staat voor de liefde? Rode en witte rozen samen in een boeket staan universeel voor een eeuwige, ware liefde en vormen wellicht het ultieme Valentijnsboeket. Alleen in Nederland staat de rode tulp ook voor de liefdesverklaring, samen met de gele tulp, die staat voor de perfecte liefde. Iedere kleur tulp staat voor verbondenheid. Hoe vond u deze les? Heeft u nog iets interessants kunnen leren? Heeft u al een Valentijn dit jaar? Of heeft u iemand op het oog? Laat het diegene weten. Laat een berichtje achter op dutchpod101.com. En tot de volgende keer.
Want to speak real Dutch from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at dutchpod101.com.
Does having a study partner help you learn a language faster? For most people, having a friend or romantic partner who is a native speaker of their target language dramatically improves their ability to master the language. In this video, we'll talk about some ways to help you build relationships with people. We'll also talk about 3 reasons having a native speaker partner can improve your language fluency. First, knowing a native speaker helps you better understand the culture. Knowing a native speaker gets you connected with the culture in ways that no lessons or textbooks ever could. Native speakers are better informed about the latest slang expressions and know interesting places to eat and hang out. Having a friend or partner who is a native speaker can dramatically improve your understanding of the language. In addition to language, you can learn about cultural practices, gestures, and relationships. Second, having a native speaker partner increases your exposure to the language. Practice makes perfect is a well-known expression that is certainly true for language learning. When you have a friend, romantic partner, or study buddy, you speak to them through text messages, phone calls, and basic interaction. These are all opportunities for you to practice the language. Making an effort to practice will help your vocabulary quickly expand beyond simple greetings, flirtatious words, and basic comments to deeper, more meaningful conversations. Third, a supportive partner is the best study aid you can find. We all make mistakes, especially when trying to learn a new language. But if you have a supportive partner, they can gently point out your mistakes and help you find better ways to express yourself. And if your native speaker study partner is also your romantic partner, your motivation will likely be even higher than someone who does not have a romantic relationship with a native speaker. Now, let's look at 3 ways our language learning program helps you learn even faster if you have a native speaker partner. First, all resources and materials are available in English and in your target language. Studying with a partner is special because it's an opportunity for both of you to learn a new language. That's why every single lesson, transcript, vocabulary list, and resource on our website is available in English and in your target language. You can learn from each other. Second, lessons are designed to help you understand and engage with culture. On our website, our focus is to help our students learn practical vocabulary and phrases that are actually used in everyday conversation. This means that from your very first lesson, you can start applying what you learn immediately. So if you want to go out to a restaurant, play games, or attend a social function with your partner, you'll have the vocabulary and phrases necessary to have a great time. Third, access to special resources dedicated to romantic phrases. If your study partner is your romantic partner, we have resources to help you communicate your feelings correctly. Our language learning program has special sections and tools to teach you love words, phrases, and cultural insights. Of course, please remember that simply being in a relationship is no substitute for studying. Communication is key to every relationship, whether romantic or not. If you fail to continue expanding your vocabulary and you stop learning the language on your own, your relationships may suffer or fizzle out. Without question, spending time with native speakers can help you dramatically improve your language proficiency. But this is no replacement for focused studying. It's essential to help facilitate better communication and master the language. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye! Being able to speak freely with native speakers is an amazing ability in itself. But being able to speak freely to a whole new group of people opens you up to possible new relationships. Most people don't realize that spending the time to build relationships in a foreign language can actually help you improve your language skills dramatically. In this video, we look at how making relationships in a foreign language can help you learn the language faster. The benefits of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's motivational. One of the greatest struggles for anyone learning a second language is motivation. 9 times out of 10, learners start out their language learning journey with loads of enthusiasm, only to see it gradually wane over time. Try as they may, it's difficult to maintain the spark they once shared with their new language. So why not borrow energy from a different part of your life? When you make relationships with people in your target language, all the excitement of a new relationship carries directly over into your learning. Suddenly, you have a very rewarding reason to improve your skills and keep practicing. As your partner or your friends get involved, you will also have the advantage of a constant source of support and encouragement. Second, it makes language learning practical. Studying vocabulary and grammar is a vital part of language learning, whether you use a podcast, textbook, app, or find yourself in a classroom. However, as great as studying is, a language really only starts to come alive once you start using it in everyday life. There's a huge difference between a scripted conversation in a lesson plan and a real-life conversation with a native speaker. Building relationships with native speakers will give you the chance to talk in your target language often. Furthermore, it will be in a way that feels natural. You'll learn the words in the context, which is hugely important. Third, it's fun. One of the greatest benefits is that it allows you to practice without having it feel like practice. Oftentimes, you'll find yourself so wrapped up in the conversation that you forget you're using a foreign language. This takes a lot of the pressure off and helps you focus on communication over trying to speak absolutely perfectly. You also get to learn about a whole new culture from your partner or friends, so you're not only learning language skills, but also about the cultures that surround your target language. The risks of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's easy to miscommunicate. When it comes to relationships, humans can easily misunderstand each other. So it can be hard when building relationships in your target language when you or your partner's lack of ability in each other's respective native tongue can lead to miscommunications that would otherwise be avoidable. Depending on the language you're speaking, a simple mistranslation or mispronounced word can drastically change the meaning of a sentence. As long as you can afford each other some extra patience and the benefit of the doubt, then you should be able to overcome this pitfall. Second, your language skills could suffer if your relationships don't work out. If all your language practice is wrapped up in one person and your relationship with that person doesn't work out, then your language learning could take a big hit. So it's best not to put all your hopes for language growth on one area, relationship or otherwise. You don't want to risk losing motivation, so try to find it in many different areas. An idea for building relationships in a foreign language. Make games out of getting to know one another. Sometimes, opening up in any new friendship or partnership can be hard. Add in the added struggle of a new language, and it can feel impossible to share your true feelings with others. So instead of trying to take first interactions so seriously and talking about the usual things like the weather or work, try to ask new, interesting questions. Try to figure out what the other person's hobbies are without asking directly, or what kind of job they have. This will give you a chance to stretch your language skills in a new way, and you'll probably get some funny answers out of it too. Being comfortable being silly or making language mistakes is a great way to bond with someone, even if you've just met. Relationships in a foreign language have a lot more benefits to offer than drawbacks. Don't be scared to open up to people and make mistakes. And for even more help to build relationships in your target language, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hi, everyone. Do you know how to say I love you in Dutch? In this lesson, you'll learn three different ways to say it. Let's start with how to express your feelings to your loved one.
Ik hou van je. Ik hou van je. Ik hou van je.
Or if you want to explain those butterflies in your stomach, you can say
Ik ben verliefd op je. Ik ben verliefd op je. Ik ben verliefd op je.
And when you feel that I love you is not enough, you can say
Woorden kunnen mijn liefde voor jou niet omschrijven. Woorden kunnen mijn liefde voor jou niet omschrijven. Woorden kunnen mijn liefde voor jou niet omschrijven.
You just learned three different ways to say I love you in Dutch. And if you're interested in learning more, don't forget to download your free Romance and Love cheat sheet, which includes romantic words, compliments, and pickup lines. Check out the description below and go to DutchPod101.com now. See you next time.
Hello, and welcome to 10 Dutch phrases you always want to hear. I am Stella, and I will be giving you a lot of compliments today. Have fun. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great. Let's start with Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. Je ziet er geweldig uit vandaag. You look great today. Always nice to hear, right? Don't use it too often, you don't want it to lose its meaning. Ik mis je. I miss you. This next one is rather sad. Ik mis je. Ik mis je. I miss you. As you can hear, the Dutch and English version of this are very similar, so it's easy to remember. You usually say this when you're on the phone with someone, in other words, when they're not actually there with you. Or you say it about someone else. You could say, for example, Ik mis mama. I miss mom. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. This is a nice one if you want to tell someone they did well. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. Dat heb je geweldig gedaan. You did a great job. You can also shorten it to goed gedaan or goed zo, meaning good job. It's a little more casual that way. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There will be a bonus at the end of the month. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. Je krijgt aan het eind van de maand een bonus. There's a bonus at the end of the month. So nice to hear. Sadly, it doesn't happen as often as we'd like. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So imagine you've gone to dinner at a friend's place and the food was great. You could say, Je kunt erg goed koken. Je kunt erg goed koken. You're an excellent cook. So if the food wasn't really good, but you still want to be polite, but you also don't really want that person to ever touch a pan or a stove again, you can say, Dankjewel voor het koken. Thank you for cooking. This is still very nice, but you don't have to actually say that dinner was amazing. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Neem even pauze. Ik ruim vandaag op. Take a break. I'll do the cleaning today. Isn't that nice? When someone tells you to just sit down and relax for a while. Maybe try using it today and say it to someone. You're sure to make some friends that way. En jij wint. And you win. So this is what you say at the end of a game. En jij wint. En jij wint. And you win. You can also say it to end an argument if you feel that maybe the other person was right after all. You can say, all right then, you win. Vooruit Omar, jij wint. It will get you some points to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. You were right. This next one is also great to admit you were wrong. Je had gelijk. Je had gelijk. You were right. Feel free to say this to me anytime. I don't mind. I really don't. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, imagine you've taken a long trip and you have brought a special gift home with you for your sister, who is Dutch. You can give it to her and you can say, ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. Ik heb iets speciaals voor je meegenomen. I've brought you something special. Now, please don't say this if it's just a t-shirt with the Eiffel Tower on it. Really save it for when you really picked out something special for your sister. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This one is really nice if you're planning a party and you want to hire a fire breather, but you're not sure if that's too expensive. And you ask that to someone, is that too expensive to hire a fire breather? And they say, het budget is onbeperkt. Het budget is onbeperkt. The budget is unlimited. This means go ahead with the fire breather and make sure everyone has their own personalized cocktail. This party is going to be great. Congratulations, you've reached the end of this class and you can now say 10 very nice things in Dutch. If you have any questions or suggestions on what you want to learn next, please let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you want to learn more, go to DutchPod101.com and I will see you next time.
You've studied for a while and are ready to talk to people and practice what you've learned. But where do you start? Starting a conversation in a new language can seem a bit intimidating. How do you just jump into it? In this video, we'll look at 5 ways to start conversations. Number 1, introduce yourself in your target language. This is usually one of the first things you learn when you start studying a new language. And sometimes starting a conversation or continuing one is as simple as introducing yourself. Number 2, talking about the weather. This is a universal talking point. People talk about the weather all over the world. And just saying, it's really nice today, is enough to start a conversation. A great way to practice your weather conversation skills is to check out our Can-Do lesson pathway. This series of lessons teaches you how to talk about the weather in your target language. Number 3, give compliments. Compliments are a great way to start a conversation. You can compliment something about your conversation partner's city, country, or something specific to them personally. Hey, your bag is super cute, or that ice cream looks delicious. These kinds of compliments can lead to further conversation about what you complimented. In this case, it could be fashion or a local restaurant. This is a great way to make quick connections with people. Number 4, ask for help. For example, you can ask for directions, ask about prices, or request recommendations for restaurants or shopping spots, and let the conversation go from there. People are usually happy to lend a helping hand to tourists who are visiting their city. Number 5, learn phrases for transactions. This can include getting a room at a hotel or telling a taxi driver where to go. When you're traveling overseas, you'll need to talk to other people in your target language. And while this might be a bit scary at first, you'll find that the people you meet are just happy that you're trying to communicate with them. So get started talking in your target language now. For even more tips on how to start conversations, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye. Great work. Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.